Welcome everyone. In this tutorial we are going to learn about how to integrate an API with your actions on Google. There is an discussion on actions on Google Plus page that the people were asking that how to integrate that API. So in this video I'm going to show how to do that. Okay, so I have an API of Indian Railway that returns the normal things like PNR status and related things. Like I will just show you. Okay, so this is the website I am using, railwayapi.com dashboard. Here you can go and register. They will give you a 500 free credit for 3 months. It's plan free, and this is an API key. This should be you shouldn't share this thing. Okay, this is your key. If anyone has this, they can access your API, and you can also upgrade and upgrade plans. I'm just going to show you the docs, how it works, API. Just close this. Okay, so you have to always obviously do this, like API functions. You have to authenticate, those things are like that. I'm going to show the PNR status. We are going to learn about PNR status, so come here. See, in PNR status you have to request an URL like this, and here you have to give the API key in this part, and here you have to give your PNR number. Right now I don't have any PR number, that will be checked, but in the end of the tutorial I will show you how to do it, and I will take an example PNR and I will show you. Okay, so after requesting this URL, you will give a JSON response. You will get a JSON response like this: the response code, debit, PNR number, the date of journey, total passengers, to a station, from a station, all things like this. You know how to access JSON, then you can simply, you can obviously, very it is simple to access these things. So for this package, to request an API, we need an request promise API, request promise package at npm, from npm. So to install request package npm, you have to use this npm install, and yeah, remember, go to the function directory, cd functions, and then run. I'm just going to pause this video after that. So our npm is request package dot install, like you can see it in package.json file. At yes, here it is. Now we are going to install a request promise. To pause this video. Now you can see, like, we also have like request promise in our package.json file. So our requirement for API is complete, and now let's build our invocation. Okay, so go to console.dialogflow.com. This video might be a little longer because we are going to do lots of things. Okay, so I'm just going to sign up with this. I don't know why it got signed out. Okay, so we are going to create an intent for PNR status. Just training, filling the training phrase. webhook call and slot filling also, and just save this. Okay, now we are going to do a new thing that we haven't done in our previous video. We are going to use an add follow-up intent. Follow-up intent means that after this intent, when you invoke this intent, the next intent will be invocated. Okay, like this. I'm going to explain a bit longer in it. Like, see, you go to a principal and say 5. What does it mean? It doesn't mean anything. But if someone principal asks the total number of students present in the class right now, you can say 5. Then now understand what the 5 means. That is called context call. We know the context what the 5 is about. So when you are using a context, then we use when you are giving a PNR status, if you are giving a PNR number input like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, our extension call doesn't know what it means. So, we are going to give an context, like we put the first thing, what is the PNR status. Then it is going to ask help me with your PNR number. And after that, you are going to give input your PNR number, and then it's going to return your status key. What is the PNR status of that number? So in this PNR status, we are going to import that. We are going to write, let's just write the PNR status, you will understand it. Okay, let me just a bit take a pause. Okay, let's just write our PNR intent, app dot intent. We know all these things. What was the name of our PNR status? Okay, and let's just past con, it is a simple intent. Con dot us. Let's just add a suggestion. Let's just put the value. Okay. So when you are going to invoke, tell me your PNR, help me with your PNR number, help with my PNR number. So it's going to return you this, please help me with your PNR number. And you are going to check my PNR status, it is going to return please help me with your PNR number. Okay, and after that you are going to give input the PNR number and it will return the PNR status. No, so we now know that this is a context, and now let's build our, it's a follow-up intent. Okay, we are going to give a custom intent. Let's just give it, just make the fallback if okay. 1 minute, just let me pause this with you. So add that a follow-up intent here like we did, and you can also edit it, but it is a training phrase, so negative examples like fallback intent and negative examples, like it means like if that intent not work, this will invoke. Okay, we are going to just enable the fulfillment here. We don't actually need any training phrase in this, just save it, get it done. Okay, so our dialog flow work is almost done. The name of our intent is PNR status fallback. Let's just edit it. Okay, to just more clear, I will just give you this input. This is the name. Okay, and let's see. Now that's the real manual. By this line we mean like whatever the conversation it is giving, taking raw input, it's not analyzing it, it's not modeling by the default dialogue flow. Whatever we are saying, it's just taking the input. So whenever we say a digit, it will take a digits. Okay, and for the sake of we will check it in our Firebase, what is happening with it. Okay, so const okay, so this is, I'm going to code an API. Just follow up with me, I will explain everything later after writing code. Okay, constant options, let it take, and the myth, I'm just building an option that we are going to pass to the argument as an argument. We are just taking a get means we are retrieving the data, not putting anything, just retrieving the data. Then we use get method. Okay, our URL is so let's go to the railway documentation, our URL will be this. Okay, we are going to give the API key here, copy the API key, and let's close this. By this, they note by this, you know that it's your account, so this is the very secret key, you shouldn't share it with anyone. Okay, and the X that is we are going to give this, this is our PNR number, so here it will be X with the dollar. X, but let's just change it, we use this symbol instead of this, then it take X as a variable. See, color changes, and obviously we are going to take JSON true. So these are the options that we are going to pass in the our function. What is this is gonna return? Okay, so obviously we are going to make the module of this constant RP. The package that we installed. This. Okay, so now we are going to return our request, we named it RP. RP is going to take the all options that we wrote there, and then we are going to pass a function in this, then a function and the parse body. The parse body means like the body that is going to parsed by the by this options. It means like it means that the JSON response that is going to return, this is our parsed body, this whole things, this is our parsed body. Okay, you can also print the JSON response, you can see what kind of JSON response it is giving. So and this parsed body will return. So now you have to think about the API, how to deal with this API. Understand, like you got this response, okay, you have now this, and what what information you want for our status, so you can get it from here. Okay, so I don't want like any train status, train or boarding point. These things are not useful for me right now in this. I'm just going to concentrate on our passengers list. What are the passengers and what are their current status or their booking status? Okay. Excuse me, my throat is not in good condition. Okay, so you know how to access the JSON, right? If you don't know, then you just check it out first, how to access JSON, then come to this. I'm assuming that you know how to access JSON. So just take, I'm going to parse body and take this passengers. The length of that person, because I'm going to loop it, loop this variable. This is our looping variable, like this. I'm going to take the length of this. What are the length of 1, 2, 3? This is the 3. For our PNR status, it will be different. Okay, you can also access like just this last variable 3 and reduce it by -1, because we know it is starting from 1, but in our coding it start with 0. So, but I'm just going to take the length of this because I think it's very easy. And just for the safe side, to if we face any error, then we can view it. console.log.y. For variable, let's okay. So we have. I'm going to make an array that will take the our returned response. We're going to save it in array. So I'm declaring an array here. And data dot push, you know how to access these things, so I'm not explaining it. Our parse body dot passengers and I, it will going to start with 0, and their current status. We are going to access the passengers, like the passengers 0, their current status. Just copy this. This is how you access an API, current status. I'm going to make an array of those numbers, all the current status, 1, 2, 3, there will be an array. And we also, we'll be also needing a booking status. So let's just booking array. What was their booking status? This will be the same. Now I'm going to use the booking status this time. You don't know silly mistakes like the typing, that's why I'm just copying pasting this here, because this is important. And this, that will be the array. When we know that our con.ask that we are going to return, it's not going to display the array, so we are going to make the string of that content. Okay, so how to make this a string? Let's just see, like str. Okay, let's just initialize with here. the array length of our API will be for I equals to, let's start from 0, I less than y, I plus plus, let's make it a string like this. Will give the taking passenger number and making it like str equals to str plus passenger status was current status. Our you have in data array and just this so in this loop this our string will be generated and that string will be returned. We will just see what our data file is. We will see what our booking status file is. Also, we can console.log our str. If we are just doing this for debugging, if our need required. And every then needs a return function, so we are going to return obviously str we created. And if it face any error, then we are going to catch it. Error, is there any error? Just so we can see our error in our directory, and we are going to return a simple dot ask. So this was our API coding for the PNR status. Let's save this and deploy it. I'm going to pause this video. So this is how we integrate an API with our actions on Google. I don't have any key an API any PNR number that to check you, but you can code it and test it by yourself. So I'm going to pause in this video right now, and if you want to share it with the person who is trying to build it, please share it. And there are different methods to do it. You can find it here, how to request promise any npm package. So okay, bye.